Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet, and it's my review of the UK lake. So I was here now for I think 7 to 10 prestige levels, so that's a lot of fishing that I did here, and I'm going to give you guys my thoughts and what I would change. So yeah, it's just going to be a little bit recap. First of all, I want to say that globally I think they did a very good job on this lake. It's a nice fishery. You can catch a lot of fish. There is a nice amount of species in this lake. You can now fish with four carps rods, so it's really fun. And I think they did a really good job. I see a lot of people that are very happy with the UK lake. It's one of the first lakes that I see that people are leaving the old lakes and are coming to a new lake. And that's very positive because that's a new system. I see the last couple of weeks, I see a lot of streamers coming into the game too. So in the past, maybe one or two were streaming. But previous weekend, we had like 11 or 15 streaming, like 100 views. And that reminds me of the old days. The old days, yeah, sometimes I think about it. It was always like that. So you had always one streamer, sometimes 100, 150 people were looking to that streamer. The community was a lot bigger. So it's very nice that I can see that. And it's very good that they did this lake, because the last couple of years, it was not so good. You need to say it as it is. No content, always the old lakes. And now they did a very fine job. But you guys know me, I always say the positive things, but the negative things too. So some things I think they need to change. Some are a little bit irritating. So it's a lot of gameplay to make the gameplay a little bit better. So first of all, I want to talk about so how the system works. So you are always fishing with three, four rods at the same time with the rod pot. But sometimes you need to switch packs because your peg is dying, you don't get bites anymore, or you need to forward the time. The main problem is, what do you need to do at the moment? You just need to get all the rods out of the water, then you can forward the time, then you need to throw all the rods back in the water, and I think that they need to put the forward, that you can use the forward with your rods in the water. So I'm not sure that's that easy, because we had it on the testing server before the Europe Lakes came, and they removed it. So I guess maybe it's not that easy to do, but I think for the gameplay it's going to be a lot better. Another thing that I want to see is, if I switch packs, that I don't need to get everything out of the water again, just go to the other pack and install it again. So what I want to see is, I switch pack, there is it all my equipment in the old pack, and I can just put it in the new pack without doing anything. That would be a lot better. Then another thing that I see a lot in this water is, everything seems always active everywhere. I think it's like an aquarium at the moment. So you guys can see it too at the moment on the video. So you see everywhere circles. So if you go to the best time of the day, you will see that activity is everywhere the same. You're going to catch on everywhere you can catch fish here, even everywhere you can catch uniques if you want. I tested it more than once. So I think that they need to go a little bit more specific on places, I think. So make a good place very active, and all those circles, I don't need to have that, to be honest. Maybe it's just an opinion, by the way, guys, because now it looks that there are like 300 million fish in this lake. You cannot see when your ground bait is becoming active, so it need to work like this, I think. So you got a couple of spots, you see maybe a carp jumping, because carp jump out of the water too. You see a small activity, you throw a little bit ground bait on it, and you see more activity on that spot. It's going to make fishing a lot easier, because you know, okay, I can throw on that spot. And maybe if the activity goes down on the spot, the circles go down on the spot too. So that's my second point that I want to talk about. Then the next one is ground bait and boilies. Ground bait, boilies and boilies. So I think they are on a very thin line, but I did some calculations. In my opinion, I think that the boilies ground bait are too expensive, because you need to use a lot of them. So I did some calculations. So for a full net, in this lake, you got 51,000 currency, according to the units that you got, to 53,000 currency. So if I need to Yeah, I get the full net. Most of the time, you got an average of 30 fish. That means you need to have 30 boilies. That's and like 10 boilies is like 3,000 currency. So that's 3 multiplied 3,000 is already 9,000 that you need to pay for the boilies. That's of course the best bait. If you want to go with ground bait and you go with the 7,000 ground bait that you need to pay, you need to feed at least 2 times. So you need to have 2 sacks. That's around 9,000. No, I'm wrong. 14,000 that you need to spend on ground bait in 1 day. So that means 9,000 plus 14,000 is 23,000. So if you get then 53,000 for a net minus 23,000 is 30,000, but that's with premium. So that's 50% more. So if you are fishing without premium, you are going to earn only 20,000 for a full day of fishing. It's on the edge. For me, that's on the edge. With premium, of course, you get 30,000 with all the expenses. And you need to calculate, because I just thought about something, you need to calculate minus 2,000 too for the day. I'm not even calculating the repairs because you're fishing with 4 rods. I'm not even calculating the net. The net is very expensive, the 300,000 one. I think for every percent damage, you need to pay like 1,000 currency or something. So it's on the edge. I would see that they lower the price a little bit with I think 30% is going to be enough, or just make the amount of boilies that you can buy not in stash of 10, but in 20 or something. So that was my next point. And then the last point, because I'm already on the last point. I would love it, and I already say it a couple of times in my previous video, that they put like a kind of rare, unique, or legendary in this lake. So you guys need to imagine how much fun would you have if suddenly you catch a carp that is 50 kilograms. That's like, whoa, everybody's going to be happy. A lot of people are going to fish a lot more. But I think already a lot of people, but it's the surprise that you are going to have. And maybe make it 10,000 or 15,000 currency. Maybe make it 1 on 1,000 fish or 1 on 500 fish. So make it very rare. I think this is an ideal place that you can do it. You can maybe implement it in the other lakes too. But that's something that we are missing at the moment. At the moment, I got the feeling you know what is coming. So the guys that just want to grind money, just want to grind that fish, grind all that gear. Yeah, that's okay. This game is okay. But the guys that want a little bit surprise, the purely fisherman, and I think at the moment we are, yeah, lacking them a little bit in this game because there is no surprise in the game. I think it's going to attract a little bit more people. But that's just my opinion. I saw it in another fishing game, and the attraction and addiction is very big. So make it rare, so that not people always think, okay, I need to farm that rare. It's like a surprise effect that you need to have. But that was it at the end. Very nice lake they did. Now the next one is the lake Mississippi, I think. So I'm expecting a little bit more. So what I want to say to the developers, just try to copy the positive points of this lake to the other Europe lakes. I'm not really sure how you can do it in Germany, because I think Germany is always going to be like the small brother of this one. But somewhere it's always you need to have like people need to catch fish, people need to think a little bit with the fishing. So the ground bait is very good. How do I make my ground bait? Where do I need to fish? And people need to make money. That's very important. And at the end, you will see people are loving the game. With the UK lake, what I got now, I think I'm going to buy a DLC. That's like 2, 3 years ago that I bought a DLC just to support the game. Because I think they did a really good job. But there is still a lot of work to do. So I think this is very good. And I want to thank you guys for watching. Have fun in the UK lake. I can say to all of you guys, just try to come here. I know it's a little bit leveling that you need to do, but it's not that much. I played other fishing games, and the grind in this game is, in my opinion, not that hard. I'm not a guy that plays every day 10, 20 hours because I need to raise my son. I need to work. I need to do all kind of jobs in the house. And still I can do it, then everybody can do it. So thanks for watching, guys. Have fun. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.